Are there aliens, and if so, why haven't they contacted us? The answer, I think, is pretty simple, although, of course, it's still just philosophical at this point, right? So we'll start off with just the idea of the Fermi Paradox, in case you're not familiar with it. So it's essentially this idea that there are billions of stars within our galaxy. Most of them, we're finding more and more, actually have planets around them, and many of them habitable. And there are billions of galaxies in the known universe with billions of stars in each of them. So when you look at these just huge astronomical numbers, and even assuming intelligent life is an extraordinarily rare event, even if it's a one in a billion event, there should still be tons of life out there. But we don't see anything out there, right? So why is that? And that's kind of where the idea of the paradox comes from. And I actually don't think that there's much of a paradox to it. I think there's actually a pretty reasonable explanation. So my thoughts are that there is life out there, intelligent life even. You have to distinguish, right? There's a big difference between microbes and intellectual beings there. And really just most of their technology, it's so advanced that we can't quite pick up on it. And there's a very good reason why they wouldn't want to contact us. It's in their best interest not to, actually. So let's start with the idea first that just lots of potential interstellar species have likely existed, but the vast majority of them probably fall apart for one reason or another. So maybe it's their own technology blowing them up, or wars, or just the loss, or the loss of desire to push their intellect any further. Maybe it slides downwards. What we'll call this is essentially the great filter. There's something that's stopping these potential aliens that we would be able to pick up on when they're interstellar from getting there. And something like that is happening. So my thoughts on the matter are that there is a great filter. Alien civilizations intentionally wait for another new up-and-coming civilization to get past that threshold and to be stable before connecting. So why would they do this? So just first think about how quickly technology advances. So we actually went from no airplanes to landing on the moon in 66 years. So if the Wright brothers were an actual company and they hired people, you could have an 18-year-old potentially working for them, but then also working for NASA on the moon project. Like, that's how short of a time frame that we're looking at, right? And chances are, if there's lots of different intelligent civilizations or potential intelligent civilizations, chances are we're not the fastest. So somebody could probably go from 0 to 60 really quickly. And once you're at the moon, like if we had the same enthusiasm and drive and need and funding behind it, we could probably become interstellar in that similar period of time there too. So now what happens? Why don't aliens contact us? So first, just think for any scientific breakthrough. The opposite side of the coin is that it can be used for destruction. So once we figured out how to split the atom, we got the positive of nuclear energy, but then we also got nuclear bombs and, almost annihilated ourselves. And now if you just think of just the level of technology that's progressed since then, essentially smaller and smaller groups, like it first started with just, the two richest nations being able to afford nuclear warheads, right, to be able to destroy a civilization. But smaller and smaller countries and smaller factions are getting the technology and the things that could be dangerous there, right? So once we have the scientific breakthrough for something that would get us interstellar, chances are the flip side of that would mean technology would be in the hands of whether individuals or just very small groups that could use it for bad things that happen, right? So they could destroy all of civilization if they wanted to, just simply because that knowledge now becomes available, that technology becomes available. Now, here's probably where the great filter comes up, right? Because if you can't peacefully coexist with your own species, it's not to the aliens' benefit to have you out there among them in the stars, right? You would just be a potential destructive habit or something that could hurt, or at the very least, be a really big annoyance to them, depending on how advanced they are, right? So it's actually better for them to let a civilization kind of run its course, most likely blow itself up. I mean, if we look at what's going on now with just politics and wars and things like that, imagine if a small terrorist group got a hold of, some sort of technology that could kill all of humanity. That probably happens and is more likely than we probably care to think about in the future. But that probably happens quite a bit. So for aliens, it's actually a good thing for that to happen. It's, they don't have to worry about those not getting past the great filter. They blow themselves up, and who knows, maybe in a billion years, another intelligent species that is valuable and peaceful can come and exchange thoughts and ideas with them, right? So again, if a civilization can't peacefully coexist with themselves, there's so much space between stars that even if we blew up the whole solar system, it wouldn't be a real loss. There'd be no chance of, you know, harming them, right? But on the other hand, if aliens did connect with us, or even just made their presence known, if you think about how quickly technology advances, a warring species or a dangerous species could very easily have politicians and tons of money thrown behind and rally everybody together within one lifetime. So we didn't solve all our, you know, geopolitical issues or anything like that. We're still the same dangerous species, but now, similar to how with the 4-minute mile, people thought it couldn't be done, and then Roger Bannister broke it, and then tons of different people in a short period of time did it because they knew it was possible. Now, when you know that interstellar space and all these advanced technologies are possible, chances are lots of different countries might start funneling money in there. We might go interstellar and get those technological breakthroughs and spread out into the galaxy in a million different ways, perhaps ways that can't be undone. And now this danger is kind of out there and present just because, you know, we rallied the people long enough to get the technology and not blow ourselves up in that instance until we already spread and we're too far out there. So that's kind of my, reasoning for why it seems like it's kind of quiet out there or what's going on. I'm curious what your thoughts are on the matter, but to me, it makes perfect sense. And we have a lot of things that we have to take care of here at home while we're advancing science and technology. Otherwise, we might be on the bad side of the great filter coming up, right? So don't forget to like, comment, subscribe. I'm curious what your thoughts are. Have a good one.